Lucille Ball was an American actress, comedian, and businesswoman who broke barriers for women in entertainment with her pioneering TV show, I Love Lucy. Lucille Ball was born on August 6, 1911, in Jamestown, New York. Growing up, Lucille loved to be the center of attention, and in 1928, she convinced her mother to let her attend acting school in New York City. Her family was struggling for money, but her mother agreed to pay for a six-week trial. But when she got to the school, Lucille was intimidated by the other girls there, and was often too nervous to speak up. After the 6 weeks, her mother received a letter from the school that said, "Lucy's wasting her time and ours." But Lucille didn't give up, and over the next few years, she did everything she could to break into show business. Finally, in 1933, at the age of 22, Lucille Ball got her first film role as a chorus girl in the movie Roman Scandals. She had no lines and was only in the background, but after getting the role, Lucille decided to follow her dreams of being a star and moved to Hollywood. Lucille Ball worked hard, appearing in over 75 movies, but she was never cast as a lead in high-budget films, instead playing side characters. But she did find success in the late 1930s and 40s by playing the lead in B-movies, lower-budget movies that used less famous actors, and because of this, she became known as the Queen of the Bees. It was on the set of one of these B-movies that Lucille Ball met bandleader Desi Arnaz. Lucille later said that when she met Desi, it wasn't love at first sight, it took a full 5 minutes. And just 6 months after they first met, the couple were married. In 1950, Lucille was cast as the kooky housewife in a radio play called My Favorite Husband. The series was so successful that CBS wanted to adapt it for television, but Lucille said she would only agree to do it if her real-life husband Desi could be her co-star. CBS were resistant because they felt that no one would believe that an American housewife would be married to a Cuban bandleader. So to prove to the network that people would watch them, Lucille and Desi created a vaudeville act of short comedy skits and took it on tour. It was a huge success, so much so that the studio agreed to cast Desi in their new show, and the characters of Lucy and Ricky Ricardo became the first interracial couple on television. TV was still pretty new in the 1950s, and shows were broadcast live, mostly from New York. But Lucille and Desi didn't want to leave their home in Hollywood, so they suggested that I Love Lucy should be shot on film, edited, and broadcast later. This was very expensive, and because of this, the studio refused. So to make their idea work, Lucille and Desi both agreed to take pay cuts and form Desi Lu Studios, so that they could produce the show themselves. I Love Lucy premiered on Monday, October 15th, 1951, and by the spring of the following year, it was the highest rated show on television, with millions of families tuning in every week to watch Lucy's wacky adventures. It was so popular that there would be a drop in water pressure during the commercials, because nobody wanted to miss a second of the show, instead waiting for the breaks to use the bathroom. I Love Lucy pioneered many of the sitcom formats that are still used today. A live studio audience, multiple cameras, and because it was recorded on film, I Love Lucy was the first TV sitcom to broadcast reruns, allowing people of every generation since to become fans. Lucille Ball was 41 when the show first aired, and had just had her first child, and when she became pregnant with her second in 1952, Lucille and Desi made the controversial decision to have the character of Lucy Ricardo be pregnant too. This was unheard of in the 1950s. Up until that point, when an actress became pregnant, their show could be cancelled, or their characters were forced to spend 9 months standing behind props to hide their growing stomach. But Lucille had no intention of hiding her pregnancy, and got letters of approval from several religious figures to prove to CBS that pregnancy wasn't something shameful. The network agreed to allow her character to be pregnant, but refused to allow the word pregnant to be said on screen. Lucille Ball gave birth to her son on January 19, 1953, the same day that her character Lucy Ricardo gave birth in the show. 44 million people tuned in to watch the episode Lucy Goes to the Hospital, and I Love Lucy fans flooded the couple with cards and gifts to welcome the new addition to the family. I Love Lucy ran until 1957, with the cast filming one-off specials for the next 3 years. But despite the perfect couple shown on screen, Lucille and Desi's marriage was anything but happy, and they divorced in 1960. They continued to run Desi Lu Studios together until November 1962, when Lucille bought Desi's half of the company, becoming the first female head of a major studio and the most powerful woman in Hollywood at the time. Lucille Ball continued acting, mostly sticking to her comedy roots in TV shows like The Lucy Show, Here's Lucy, and Life with Lucy, but she will always be remembered most fondly as Lucy Ricardo, the star of I Love Lucy, a show still loved by millions and watched all over the world. Lucille Ball died at the age of 77, on April 26, 1989. On the following Monday, many people in America shared a moment of silence at 9 p.m, I Love Lucy's time slot from over 30 years before. Not only did Lucille Ball bring joy to millions of people, she paved the way for women in comedy and in show business. She proved to the world that women were more than just what they looked like. Women could pull silly faces, make a fool of themselves, and still be the star of the show. And that success can come at any point in your life if you work hard and keep reaching for your dream. As Lucille Ball once said, Love yourself first, and everything else falls into line. You really have to love yourself to get anything done in this world.